So today in lecture number 4, we will be going through the methodology, how to prepare a bar chart and how a bar chart will be connecting the various activities and how it will be helpful in planning. Earlier in lecture number 3, we have discussed briefly what is a bar chart and how you can construct a bar chart, that we will be able to understand in this lecture number 4. Now, bar chart for various activities. So that means we have to connect the activities. First of all, earlier we have discussed that we have to do the work breakdown structure. We have to prepare work breakdown structure. That means any project can be divided into various number of activities, and those activities are planned for their execution in the form of a bar chart. Now let us take a problem related to a project which is having 7 number of activities. So in this bar chart, in this picture, you are able to view here, and we can understand that there is a bar chart is shown, and along x-axis we have taken time in days, that means how many days for one activity will take to complete. And along y-axis there are activities, or you can say jobs. So as we have discussed, this particular project, it may be a small project having 7 number of activities. So these 7 number of activities are PQRSTUV and having time duration 10, 5, 10, 7, 5, 8 and 15 days respectively. So that means this activity P will be requiring 10 days to cover up, to complete this activity, and correspondingly other activity duration is mentioned. So here you can see we have drawn a bar chart for activity P, Q, R, S, T, U, V. So these bar chart, length of the bar chart will be giving the information that this activity, suppose this activity, if we talk about activity P, this P activity bar chart length is 0 to 10. So that means 10 days will be required to complete this activity. Similarly, Q having requirement of 5 days, R requires 10 days, and so these P and Q start simultaneously at 0 time. Both are independent to each other, but one thing is clear from this bar graph, bar diagrams, that Q can be completed earlier than P. That means Q activity can be completed before the completion of P. Now second point of observation is this activity R. This activity R starts only when after the completion of Q activity. That means this R activity may be related to Q activity, because it can only start after the completion of Q activity. It cannot be started before the completion of Q activity. Then S activity. Now, S is independent of R. No doubt it is independent of R. It starts even and completes earlier than R. It starts before the commencement of activity R, and it also get completed before the completion of activity R. So if we try to understand these 4 activities, you will find that some of the activities are starting at the same time, and some of the activities are related to the other activity. That means they can start, as we have discussed, activity R can only start when Q is complete. But S activity is independent of R, that means it does not belong to R. It can start before the start of R, and it can complete before the completion of activity R. Now see here, activity T. Activity T starts after S. That means activity T can be started after the completion of activity S. So they are dependent on each other. If now you can understand, if S activity get delayed, then definitely T activity starting time will be delayed. So these are dependent on each other. That means it starts after the completion of S, but these R and S activity, they are independent of each other. So T can start only after S is complete. Now U activity can start. Now see, activity R as well as activity U, they are starting at the same time. That means their starting day is same. Even their completing day is also same. So U and R can start simultaneously. U and R can start simultaneously when Q is complete. Now this Q is complete. This R activity can start only after the completion of Q. U activity is also can start after the completion of Q. So that means from this bar chart, we are able to understand that some of the activities are depending upon the completion time of activity, another activity, and some of the activities can be independent. Now, if suppose this activity Q get delayed, then definitely it will affect the starting time of activity R, and ultimately completion time will also affect. And similarly, if activity U, it can only start after Q. So that means if Q is activity, if it get delayed, that means U activity can also delayed. So each number one of the activities may be depending on number of other activities, or number of activities may depend upon some another type of activity. So we have to take careful while planning all the details. Now let us talk about the last activity, V. Now V start maybe on the 10th day. So V can start when P and S are complete. Now you can see here, there may be some error in the graph. Now this S activity, when it complete, then V can start. And this activity S and P have the same completion time. So it can only start after the activity completion time of activity S. And another thing, you can say P and Q are the starting activity, and V will be the completion activity. And when V will be getting completed, that will be the completion time of the project. So end of V activity will be marked as completion of the project. So from this small example, we are able to understand that how to break down a project or a job into number of sub-jobs or number of sub-activities, and correspondingly deciding their duration, we can easily draw a bar chart which will be helpful for all of us. So here, from these number of bars, you are able to understand that Q is very important activity. That means we have to take care about Q activity so that it should not be delayed, otherwise other activity will be delayed, and ultimately you can say project will delay. Now development of bar chart. How to develop a bar chart? What are the things which we have to keep in mind? So step number one is breakdown. Break down the project into various activities or jobs or operations, each representing manageable unit for planning and control. You may remember in earlier lectures we have done a breakdown of small project. That project was installation or execution of boundary wall. So boundary wall we have divided into number of activities. So this similarly, you have to break down a project into smaller number of activities which can be defined independently. So you can easily define those activities with some duration. Second step is after breaking down the structure, breaking down the project into various activities. Second is to decide. Now, how to decide? The method to be employed in the execution of the project. Now, here you have to decide that which will be the method you have to employ for the execution of the project. As well as for each activity or operation or task, again you have to decide that if you are dividing a project into number of activity, as we have seen in the earlier diagram PQRS, then you have to decide that what are the requirements or what are the methodology to complete different activities. So each activity, what are the methods you have to employ for the completion of the activity. Also decide the sequence in which the activity are to be completed. Now let us consider there is a project and you have divided it into 10 number of jobs, now 10 number of activities. Then you have to list out those activities, and after that you have to decide that what will be the sequence of these activities. Which activity will be the first activity, which activity will be the second activity, like that. Third step is assign. Here you have to assign the duration of time for the completion of each activity. So based on your experience, based on information available with you, you have to decide that what will be the duration for each activity. Once the activities are separated and choice of method is made, it is possible to estimate the time required for the completion of each activity. So first of all, break down the structure of the project. Then you have to decide which will be the activities. Then we will be assigning the time duration for the completion of each activity. Then step number four, present. That means you have to represent all the details, the above information, in a bar chart. You have to present all the information. Information mean number of activity, name of activity, duration of activity on a bar chart, and indicating the relative position of the activities. Now I'm giving you one problem for practice, which you can try at home. And then in the discussion class, you should come up with the solution and we will be discussing about it. What are the priorities of the activities and what will be the duration of the project. So you have to prepare a bar chart for finalization of design and work order for a building project as per the detail below. Now detail is given, there are number of activities A to G, and description is given. Which activity? Now here A activity, site selection and survey, it will take 4 weeks. Similarly, design, preparation of drawings, preparation of specification and tender document, then tendering, then selection of a contractor and award of work. So possible time for their completion is mentioned here. Now you have to go through the details. First of all, you have to arrange all the activities, that which activity will be the first activity, second, third, fourth, and when it will start. So you have to prepare a bar chart and then come up with the solution in the discussion class. Thank you.